Dance has always been a part of man's existence. Dance is an art and is used by various people for different reasons. For some people, dance is an expression of themselves. For some others, dance is a form of recreation. Other people use dance for exercise, and some other people have used dance as a money-making venture. There are different styles of dancing. There's the African contemporary dance. There's the Western contemporary dance. We have hip-hop, salsa, cha-cha, and so many other styles. Just like any other skill, dance can be taught and learned, and many have made efforts to teach and learn this art. Classes are organized by various people all around the world. Some of these people are Matt Stefanina, Will the Beast, Kathy, Alexander Chong, Tricia Miranda, and in the University of Ibadan, one of such dance classes is the Savvy Dance Class, organized by Moronke Aino.
Hi, my name is Aino Moronke. I am a dancer and a choreographer. I love dancing. So take a deep breath and let it go. I teach lyrical hip hop majority of the time. I love dancing so much. It is an outlet for me. It is one way to release myself of and to relieve myself of pressure, and I just enjoy myself when I'm dancing and no cares in the world, just, you know, giving to the movements and the motion. When I came to the University of Ibadan, I saw that UI has a dance community of its own. So we have several crews, we have several friends who dance together. We have people from different faculties who come around to dance.
People prepping.
We have church crews who dance together. But also, I realized that it lacked the wow factor needed, especially in hip-hop. While dancing hip-hop, there are things that require, that make it so amazing, that people imagine that they cannot do it. But then it's not so hard to do. Those are the things that make things outstanding, and I realized that it was somewhat lacking, and I decided that I would develop myself personally. And over time, as I did, I became better. I watched dance videos, I watched international choreographers do their things, and they do tutorials, and you learn over time. Then my friends encouraged me to start the dance class when I pitched it on to them, and they said, "Go girl, you can do it." And yes, I did it. One would wonder how I merged dance and my academic life. But unlike my academic life, that is all, you know, deadlines and whatnot, dance is actually fun for me. I don't need to sit down and rack my head for hours if I can think of everything. So it's quite easy for me to just do my thing. So I just hear a song and this song sounds nice and we could dance to it, and then the routine comes up, and then the routine lasts 1 minute, you know, and then you're good, and then you're able to teach. Each song has its own peculiarity, so with each song comes a different thing to do with dance. So it's quite easy for me to actually merge my academics with dance. So as a finalist, one would imagine that I would have started dance class a long time ago and now I'll be just established, but it's all working out well.
Dance class is something amazing. It's a nice idea, and coming from a student, it's really nice. And I'll keep encouraging. I'm a student to dance class, and hopefully I'll come and dance again on it. I'm really proud of her.
You have to teach people who imagine they know how to dance, and then they realize that it's much tougher than they thought it would be. But then you have to encourage them and tell them it's not so hard. People said I should stop saying this, but it's hard to not say it's not so hard, but it's not so hard. Anybody can dance actually. So.